Haribo.
Haribo Maharaj.
OK. 早上好。
拜拜。开始吗？三点钟。
好的，好的。
来昆特之音服务员聆听，今天是2020年8月4日。我们又荣幸地邀请到了 Bhakti Vaishnava Singha Swami Maharaj 给我们讲解《大博迦梵甘露》，敬请聆听 ，Hare Krishna。
Om Gyana Timurandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Vancha Kalpa Tarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhai Vacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha。Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pustaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Iti Namne Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pricharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschacha Deja Taline Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nichananda Shri Advaita Gadara Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. We're recounting the story of Gop Kumar, a cowherd boy from Vrindavan, who was given a mantra, and by the power of the mantra, he could travel to many places. So at this point in the story, he had come to the place of liberation beyond the material universe. And he met with Lord Shiva, and he heard the glories of Vaikuntha from the son of Lord Shiva, Ganesh. So when
Lord Shiva recounts the glory of Vaikuntha, Ganesh. Okay. 然后他遇到了主西瓦，主西瓦的儿子 Ganesh 就给他讲述了Vaikuntha的荣耀。
So when Gop Kumar heard about Vaikuntha, he awakened a desire to go there, but he felt himself very unfit and unqualified.
Gop Kumar 一听到Vaikuntha的荣耀，立刻就唤醒了想要去Vaikuntha的欲望，但是他觉得自己还没有资格。
Gop Kumar was feeling very great distress, thinking that he wouldn't be able to go to Vaikuntha, and Lord Shiva saw him in this state. Lord Shiva could understand his mind, and he picked him up after, because he'd fallen on the ground, he picked him up and he spoke to him, spoke to Gop Kumar.
Gop Kumar 呢就觉得自己没有资格去那里，就感到非常有压力，然后他就非常想要去那里，但是就就看出了他的这个心思，明白了他的愿望。因为Gopa Kumar他就晕倒在地了，所以主师吧就把他抱了起来。
And Lord Shiva told him, he said, you know, don't feel so bad. He said, even people like Parvati and I, we're like you. We would like to live there forever in Vaikuntha, but we can't go there.
主师吧安慰他说，你不要内心感到很糟糕难过，即便是 Parvati 和我。我们都像一样，也想永恒地居住在那里，但是呢，我们却去不了。
Yeah, Lord Shiva said that to go to that place is very difficult. Even liberated souls pray to go there. Even Brahma's sons and even Brahma himself has to work very hard to try to go there. And Lord Shiva says, so do I.
那个地方是很难去的， 即便是解脱和灵魂，他们都渴望去那里，包括主 Brahma、 主 Brahma 的儿子，甚至我自己，我们都努力的想去那里，但是我们却去不了。
So, you know, liberated impersonalists and demigods, they all want to get liberation.
解脱的非人格主义者还有半神人们全都想要解脱。
Yeah, the goal, but the goal is to go to Vaikuntha.
但是目标是去 Vaikuntha.
But they haven't achieved that yet. They're trying to become qualified to go there. Until we perfectly perfect our religious duties, unless we're very pure, and we give up all.Our selfish desires, then we won't be able to go there.
除非我们已经做履行各自的宗教职责，达到完美了，而且非常的纯粹，放弃了自私的欲望，否则的话是去不了百困他的。
We need to get the mercy of Lord Hari. To get the mercy of Lord Hari, if you have the mercy of Lord Hari 100 times, then you get the post of Brahma.
Yeah, sorry, if we haven't get the mercy of Lord Hari 100 times, then we have to go to Lord Brahma.
No, if we get the mercy of Lord Hari, 100 times, that mercy of Lord Hari is multiplied 100 times, then we can become Brahma. We get the position of Brahma.
Okay. 如果我们得到了主 Hari 的仁慈100倍，这样我们才能去主 Brahma 那儿。
And if you get 100 times again that mercy, then you can become like me, like Lord Shiva.
Okay, 就是再重新翻一遍。刚才说的是，如果得到了主 Hari 的仁慈，乘以100倍可以得到 Brahma 的位置。如果这一份仁慈再乘以100倍，那就可以得到了我主 Shiva 的地位。
Yeah, and if we can get the mercy of the Supreme Lord, then we can go to Vaikuntha.
如果得到了至尊主的仁慈，我们就可以去 Vaikuntha 了。
But you have to get more mercy than.Even Lord Shiva can give. You have to get 100 times more the mercy of Lord Shiva to go to Vaikuntha.
但是要去 Vaikuntha 的话，要得到的仁慈要超过主 Shiva 所给予的仁慈，要得到100倍主 Shiva 的仁慈才能去 Vaikuntha.
So you can see how difficult it is to go into Vaikuntha.
就这样。我们可以看出来，去百昆塔是多么困难的一件事儿。
So some demigods like Lord Shiva, they become qualified to go to Vaikuntha only after the whole universe is destroyed.
有些半神人，他们能去百昆塔，是只有等到整个宇宙毁灭之后，才能够去百昆塔。
But the pure devotees, by the mercy of Lord Vishnu, they don't need to wait for that. They can go immediately.
但是纯粹的奉献者，即是主威士的仁慈，不用等到整个宇宙毁灭，就可以立刻去外昆塔了。
So one who deserves to go to Vaikuntha, they should be a devotee of the Lord. So Lord Shiva tells Gop Kumar, he said, you deserve to go to Vaikuntha because you're a devotee. You're the son of a cow. You're the son of a cowherd man. Your father had cows, and the kid said at Govardhan. So you're from the holy place. You're a devotee.
你的父亲是一个牧牛郎，你是牧牛郎之子，你的父亲还拥有母牛，你们都是高丹山的居民，所以呢，你们是圣地的居民，你们是可以去百坤塔的。
And you're also the disciple of a Brahmana who is a devotee.
而且你本身也是一位 Brahmana的门徒，而这位 Brahmana他是奉献者。
And you chant the Lord's mantra. You're faithfully chanting the Lord's mantra which your guru gave you. So you're a good devotee, so you should go to Vaikuntha. And Lord Shiva tells Gop Kumar, he said, just now we're in this place, this is the place of Sayujya, impersonal liberation. Right. For people who are renounced, then it's, you know, this is the goal, to come to this place.
对那些有气绝的人士，这是他们的目的地，他们来到这里。Yeah,
they have no material desires.
他们没有一丝一毫的物质欲望。So,
so they're happy just to come to this place, but the devotee won't be happy in this place for long.
这些上述的气绝人士呢，他们来这里的感恩，他们是心满意足的。可是奉献者，他们不会对于长久的待在这里感到满意。
These impersonalists, they go back again into the material world. They're not able to maintain this place. But for a devotee, there's no ecstasy there because there's no devotional service.
他们停留在这里的没有什么狂喜，因为他们是主的奉献者，他们这里在这里没有奉献服务。So
Lord Shiva tells Gop Kumar that you don't need to stay here. It's not good for your devotion.
主Shiva告诉Gopa Kumar，你没有必要留在这里，这对您的奉爱不好。
Mahakalapur, this is a place where the impersonalists go. It's outside the covering of the universe. Lord Krishna and Arjuna had gone there to get back the sons of the Brahmana.
Krishna and Arjuna 先前为了找回 Brahmana 的死去的儿子们曾经来到过这一地方。
So impersonalist sannyasis, they all want to go to that place, Mahakalapur.
非人格的 sannyasi 们都想去这个 Mahakalapur.
But these, because these people are not devotees, they don't have the proper knowledge to understand anything higher than the impersonal Brahman.
但是这些非人格的 sannyasi, 他们没有正确的知识去理解超越于 Brahman 之上的地方。
So that Brahmana who was residing in Dwarka, he wanted to get his sons back. So he came there to Dwarka, and then Krishna and Arjuna, they'd gone there and they brought back the sons.
那位Brahmana, 他就去了 Dwarka, 想去讨回他的儿子们。所以 Krishna 和 Arjuna 就去了这个地方来去要回 Brahmana 的儿子们。
The Brahmana didn't want his sons to stay in that Mahakalapur because there's no devotion there. He wanted them to taste Krishna Bhakti.
这位 Brahmana 可不希望自己的儿子们待在 Mahakalapur 这个地方，因为这个地方没有什么奉爱，他希望自己的儿子拥有 Krishna Bhakti。
So he brought them back to Dwarka. In Dwarka, they can get some Krishna Bhakti.
这位 Brahmana 就把自己的儿子又弄回了 Dwarka， 在 Dwarka 可以得到 Krishna Bhakti。
Yeah, the people during the time of Lord Krishna, when Lord Krishna was present in Dwarka, all the people of Dwarka had spiritual bodies, Satchidananda bodies.
主 Krishna 停留在 Dwarka 期间，所有 Dwarka 的居民们，他们拥有的躯体都是拥有的 Satchidananda 灵性的躯体。
And they had no interest in material happiness.
而且对物质的快乐没有一丝一毫的兴趣。
So that's why the Brahmana wanted to bring his sons back to Dwarka.
正因为这个原因。这位 Brahmana 希望把自己的儿子们再带回到 Dwarka。
But Lord Shiva tells Gopkumar, even here, you can see the Supreme Lord.
主 Shiva 又对 Gopkumar 说，即便在这个地方，你也能亲眼见到至尊主。
Your guru gave you the mantra, so that through that mantra, you get the mercy of the guru, and he will create the desire for you to see Krishna. And when you have the desire to see Krishna, Krishna will reveal himself to you.
你的 guru 呢，给了你这首 mantra， 它特别仁慈，你可以通过这首 mantra。来祈求能够见到 Krishna， 有拥有这个欲望。当你有这样的欲望， Krishna 就会揭示给你。
The impersonalists, they come to Mahakalapur for impersonal liberation, but Gopkumar, he wanted to see the Lord, and he saw Lord Mahakala, Vishnu.
非人格主义者来 Mahakalapur 这个地方，他们就想到达这里，但是呢 Gopakumar 他在寻找主，所以他可以见到 Mahakala， 也就是 Vishnu 本人。
So Gopakumar is feeling ecstasy due to Lord Shiva's mercy.
也由于主 Shiva 的仁慈，勾帕库玛就感受到狂喜。
He wanted to ask about the Vaikuntha because there were these people from Vaikuntha who'd come, very beautiful people with four arms. They'd come from Vaikuntha, so Gop Kumar wanted to know about them, but he was shy. He didn't want to say anything.
Gopa Kumar 呢就想询问有关 Vaikuntha 的事情，因为有一些Vaikuntha 的居民来自 Vaikuntha，他们都长着四臂。库玛讲渴望了解那里，但是他很害羞，所以他没有开口说话。
But these associates, these Vaikuntha people, when they heard Lord Shiva speak, then they were very respectful to him, and they spoke to him. They spoke to Lord Shiva with great humility and pleasure.
这些百昆特的同游们，他们听到主师傅说话，他们对主师傅都非常的尊敬有加。然后他们想，他们就对主师傅说话了，他们很谦卑而很快乐。
Right. Gop Kumar, he wanted to know why the Vaikuntha people had come there. So they're going to say.They're going to explain to Gop Kumar why they've come. But first, they want to say something to make Gop Kumar feel a little more comfortable.
Gopa Kumar, he wants to know why these Vaikuntha residents came. So, these people will explain the reason they came. But first, they will say some words.
Because Gop Kumar is worried that he's not fit to go to Vaikuntha, so the Vaikuntha Vasis are going to speak to him.
Because Gop Kumar is worried that he's not fit to go to Vaikuntha, so these Vaikuntha residents are going to speak to Gop Kumar.
And so the people from Vaikuntha are speaking to Lord Shiva, and they say to Lord Shiva, there's no difference between you and the Supreme Lord. You are also our Lord is the master of Vaikuntha, and you're not different from him. Just as there's no difference between you and the Supreme Lord Vishnu, there's no difference between your wife Gauri and the wife of Lord Vishnu, Rama.
就跟主师傅说，您和百昆塔的主人二者之间没有区分，恰似至尊主威殊和您本人也没有区分一样，而且您的妻伴侣 Gauri 和百昆塔的之主的妻子 Rama 二者之间也没有分别。
Yeah, Rama means Rama Devi. She's the wife. She's Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune. Another name for Lakshmi is Rama Devi. So the people from Vaikuntha say to Lord Shiva, you and your wife, they can also go and live in Vaikuntha, they can live in Lord Vishnu's home, because you are renounced, and you're his best friend, and you're his incarnation.
Vaikuntha 的居民们就跟主师傅说，你和你的妻子，你们也可以居住在 Vaikuntha， 居住在主 Vishnu 的家，因为你是主 Vishnu 最好的朋友，也是主 Vishnu 的化身。
But you were just saying that you can't go there. You said, and the people from Vaikuntha say, yeah, that is the proper mood of a devotee of the Lord. A devotee should think like that.
你刚才说 你不能去外昆塔，你没有资格继续居住在外昆塔的恰当的资格。他们这么想是很适当的。
Actually, Lord Shiva and his wife, they can go to Vaikuntha any time.
实际上呢，主 Shiva 和他的妻子随时随刻的都可以去 Vaikuntha。
So the Vaikuntha people say to Lord Shiva, "You are always praised by the devotees, and because you like to inspire others, you like to bring people to devotional service." So you are very much appreciated by the devotees.
Vaikuntha 的居民们就跟主师傅说：“你恒常的受到奉献者们的赞扬，因为您总是激励人们，把他们带到奉爱服务当中，所以奉献者们对你充满了感激之情。”
And of all the Lord Vishnu's incarnations, you are the greatest.
在所有主的化身当中，你是最伟大的。
So Lord Shiva is, he heard himself being praised. He felt uncomfortable. He didn't say anything.
主 Shiva 听到对自己的这番赞美之词，他就感到内心很不舒服，所以他就一言不发。
But the people from Vaikuntha, who were all Lord Shiva's friends, they embraced Gop Kumar and they spoke to him.
And 这些来自 Vaikuntha 的居民们都是主 Shiva 的朋友，他们便拥抱了 Gopa Kumar， 随后对 Gopa Kumar 讲了一番话。
So we should see Lord Shiva how saintly he is, what good qualities he is, that he doesn't like to hear himself.
我们从这里可以看出主 Shiva 他是拥有圣洁的品质，拥有优秀的品质，他不想听到任何对自己的赞美。
Also he's very kind and compassionate to other people.
而且他对其他人也非常的仁慈和充满怜悯。
So now the Vaikuntha people are speaking to Gop Kumar and they tell Gop Kumar that that we count you among the Lord's devotees, that we know you are also a devotee.
Vaikuntha 的人士呢，又随后对 Gopa Kumar 说话，我们把你也算作主的奉献者，因为你本身就是奉献者。
Yeah, so Gop Kumar is just like Lord Shiva can go to Vaikuntha. They told Gop Kumar, "You can also go to Vaikuntha. Don't worry, you're also a devotee."
他们就对 Gop Kumar 说，就像主 Shiva 可以随时去 Vaikuntha， 你也可以去 Vaikuntha。
You're chanting Vishnu mantra, so you're also a good Vaishnava, a good devotee, and good devotee, pure devotees, they can go to live in Vaikuntha.
你在念诵着 Vishnu mantra， 你可以去 Vaikuntha， 你是奉献者，而且你是纯粹的奉献者，因此你可以去 Vaikuntha 居住在那里。
And then the Vaikuntha Vasis told Gop Kumar about his guru, that we know you're a disciple of a guru, and your guru, he's a Mathura Brahmin, and his name is Jayanta.
这些来自 Vaikuntha 的居民们听到了 一位孤的门徒，他是 Mathura 的一位 Brahma 呢，他名字叫 Jayanta。
And he is an incarnation of Krishna. So you're very fortunate. Your guru is an incarnation of Krishna.
你很幸运， 因为你的 guru 是 Krishna 的一位化身。
So they tell Gopakumar that we've come here to this place of Sayujya, of liberation, only for your sake.
他们又对 Gopakumar 接着说道，我们来到这个 Sayujya 之地，只是为你而来。
We want to help you understand what you should do. We want you to help you to reach Vaikuntha.
我们希望帮助你明白你该做什么。我们希望帮助你达到 Vaikuntha.
We want you to be fully engaged in devotional service, the 9 different kinds of devotional service.
我们希望让你完全从事于九种奉爱服务。
So he should be ready to leave this Mahakalapur, and he should not be attached to just doing any rituals, but he should be attached to devotional service.
所以你应该做好准备离开 Mahakalapur， 你不应该依附任何仪式，而应该依附奉献服务。
And they tell Gopakumar, you should honor the Srimad Bhagavatam and any scripture which promotes devotional service. Hear about them regularly.
他们就跟 Gopakumar 说，你应当荣耀圣典博迦瓦坛和以及荣耀任何奉盖服务的经典。你应该每天，你应当定期的、有规律的来聆听。
When you hear the Lord's pastimes, then that sound vibration will enter your ears, and you will begin to taste the nectar, awaken your love for the Lord.
你应当聆听主的逍遥时光，当这个音阵进入到你的耳孔的时候，这种甘露就会唤醒。
And quickly you'll be able to go to the abode of the Lord, go to the Vaikuntha, the spiritual world. So Gopakumar, he didn't really know anything about the 9 kinds of devotional service. He only had been given the mantra by the guru and he was chanting it, but he didn't know about 9 kinds of devotional service.
Gopakumar 呢，实际上对九种奉爱服务并不了解，他只是他的 guru 赐予了他这首 mantra， 但是他对九种奉爱服务还不甚了解。
But here, the Vaikuntha Vasis are telling him, you have to hear. Hearing is very important.Hear from the scriptures.
这些外昆达巴西们就跟他说，你必须得聆听经典，可是非常重要的。
Of course, devotional service can be done in any of the 9 different kinds, but the best possible discipline, which can easily help you to get the ultimate goal, is this hearing.
当然了，九种奉献服务都是很好的，但是最好的奉献服务是聆听。这一个聆听呢，可以轻易的帮助你能够达到你想要去的目标。
In the beginning, anyway, you have to hear.
无论如何，一开始必须要聆听。
Yeah, devotional service is better than karma or jnana or yoga.
奉献服务胜过 karma， 胜过 dhyana， 胜过 yoga。
All the other benefits, which may be offered by the other systems, you can get through devotional service.
赐予的好处，通过奉献服务全能够达到。
But advanced devotees, they don't have an interest in these other benefits which are offered by the other processes.
进步的奉献者们对于这些其他的程序、其他方法所能给予的其他的好处不感兴趣。
Devotees are not interested with material, they have no material desires, they don't desire liberation, they don't desire mystic powers.
奉献者呢，没有什么物质欲望，也没有解脱的欲望，也并不想获得玄秘功能。
Devotees who know about devotional service, they can practice all different 9 kinds of bhakti to get, and they can get the taste, they can taste the sweetness of service to Krishna.
奉献了解奉献服务的奉献者们修习九种奉献服务的方法，这样就品味到了对 Krishna 的
Bhakti. So they begin with hearing and then chanting, and in this way they get a sweet taste and they can go on to practice the other 9 kinds, the other total of 9 kinds of bhakti.
奉献者一开始是聆听，接着是念唱诵，逐渐的他们品味到奉爱服务的甜美滋味，进而他们继续履行所有九项奉爱服务。
Any one of these 9 kinds of bhakti can help us to get pure love for Krishna.
这九项奉爱服务的任何一项都能够帮助奉献者们获得纯粹的奉爱。
But if we have some other goal,if you have some other kind of desire, some material desire, then that will, then you will never be able to go to Vaikuntha.
但是呢，如果还有其他的目标，还有其他的物质欲望，那就永远去不了 Vaikuntha.
We want to develop love for Krishna, cannot have material desires.
我们希望发展起对 Krishna 的纯爱，就不能拥有其他的欲望了。
So we have to purify our heart to get rid of all the pride and all the attachment, the ignorance.
我们必须要净化我们的内心，去除一切的骄傲，一切的依附，一切的愚昧。
So wherever there is devotional service, then the Supreme Lord will appear.
无论哪里有奉爱服务，至尊主就出现在哪里。
That place will become as good as Vaikuntha.
而这样的地方就和 Vaikuntha 一模一样。
Of course, we still have to respect the real Vaikuntha, the actual Vaikuntha.I have special respect for that place because that's where the Lord always is seen. He's always there.
当然了，我们必须要尊重真正的 Vaikuntha. 我们给予这样的真正的 Vaikuntha 特殊的尊敬，因为主是永远居住在那里的。
It's only in Vaikuntha that one can see the real devotion that one can actually no wait no it's only in Vaikuntha that devotion to him can be actually realized, fully realized.
Because 只有在真正的 Vaikuntha 才能够 完整的、完完整整的、彻底的觉悟到奉爱。
Because in Vaikuntha, there's no disturbance, and there's the we have the company of all the surrendered devotees.
因为在 Vaikuntha 是没有任何干扰的，而且能得到所有臣服的奉献者的陪伴。
In the material world, there's always so many obstacles. Different situations come, which make it difficult for us.
在物质世界呢，充满着各种各样的障碍，还有各种各样艰难的处境。
But in Vaikuntha, there's none of these obstacles.
在 Vaikuntha, 没有任何这种上述的障碍。
So we have to give special respect for Vaikuntha, the abode of the Lord.
我们必须对 Vaikuntha 给予特殊的尊敬。Vaikuntha 是主的居所。
So the people from Vaikuntha are still speaking. They're telling Gop Kumar that the devotional service is not just some activity which we do with the body, the senses, and the mind. It's not just only that.
Vaikuntha 的这些人们继续对 Gopa Kumar 讲话，奉献服务不仅仅限于用躯体、感官、心意来从事的活动。
Yeah, it's beyond the material modes of nature. It's not ordinary activities.
它超越了物质自然品质的。物质自然的品质，它不是普通的活动。
Because the Vaikuntha people have been telling Gop Kumar he should do devotional service, so we may think this is just something, some practice, some ritual which you're supposed to do, but it's not.
因为 Vaikuntha 的这些人们告诉 Gopa Kumar。要做奉爱服务，可能我们就会想啊，也许是一些休息、一些练习、一些仪式而已，但是并非如此。
Just like when we hear, we may say, well, hearing is done with the ear, but you see, the hearing is not material; it's a spiritual activity performed only with our spiritual senses.
比如说聆听。聆听呢，我们可能可以以为就是用耳朵听听而已，但实际上呢，这并不是个物质的，而是灵性的，是用灵性的感官来去从事的活动。
So devotional service is understood in the heart of the devotees who are free from the material modes.
奉献服务是奉献者的内心。能够理解奉献服务，而这样的奉献者呢，他们已经摆脱了所有物质的品质。
Of course, we may say, well, we're conditioned souls. How can we ever do activities with spiritual senses?
我们会想，我们都只是受条件限制的灵魂而已，怎么可能用灵性的感官来做奉爱服务呢
？But We just need a little purification, just a little purification that we can begin to start transcendental hearing and chanting.
我们只需要得到一些净化，就可以开始超然的聆听和念诵。
And as we go on chanting, our senses become more purified, and we become more and more engaged in spiritual activity.
随着我们继续的聆听，继续唱诵，感官进一步得到净化，我们就可以从事其他的奉爱服务。
So as we go on, we become more and more ecstatic in devotional service.
随着这个进展，随着这样奉献服务进展下去，我们就会在奉爱服务当中感受到狂。
And one day, devotee will become very pure, fully pure at heart, and he will reach the Vaikuntha, and he will realize all the varieties of devotional service.
终有一天，奉献者的内心得到完全的净化，就能够去Vaikuntha，能够在那里看到各种各类的奉爱服务。So devotee
has to, we have to learn to make a distinction between matter and spirit. What is material and what is spiritual?
奉献者要学习区分物质与灵性。Right,
we give up the material and we take up the spiritual.
放弃物质来接受拥抱灵性。
If we get some if we awaken transcendental knowledge, then we get freed from the material attachments.
一旦我们获得了超然的知识，就能够摆脱物质的依附。
So devotional service is much better than any ordinary activities of the material world.
奉献服务要远远优越于物质世界的任何普通活动。If
devotional service was just made up of activities of material senses and material objects, that wouldn't be spiritual.
倘若奉爱服务呢，仅仅是就是物质世界的用物质的感官从事的活动，那就并不是灵性的了。
So if somebody is given up, if somebody's become purified, then he won't be interested in these material activities.
一个人他得到净化之后，就不再对物质活动感兴趣。
So somebody who's a little advanced in the activities of devotional service, they will know what's good and what's not good for their Krishna consciousness.
一个在奉爱服务当中进步的人士，知道哪些对Krishna知觉有利，哪些不利于他的Krishna知觉。
When we have renounced it, if somebody is not interested in devotion, then they won't want to go to Vaikuntha. No, they should just only go to the abode of liberation. Just like the impersonalists, they don't like, you know, they think devotional service is material, so they don't need to go to Vaikuntha. If you want to go to Vaikuntha, you need to get the blessings of a devotee.
奉献者的祝福。
Even materialists think devotional service they think it's just karma. They think it has nothing to do with, it's not spiritual.
奉爱服务认为是不是灵性的活动。
So we let them think that way. But let them talk in that way. They do not know anything. And even they cannot understand the qualities of the devotees. So, okay, we don't argue with them. So devotional service requires discipline. Just we have to follow the discipline. Just like in Varnashram Dharma, there are different rules and duties to be done. So in Bhakti Yoga also. But still we should understand bhakti is not material. It's not just a function of the material body. It should be performed on the spiritual platform. Just like in Vaikuntha, the transcendental nature of devotional service is easily understood. And you can see that in Vaikuntha, all the people, all the devotees there, they all have spiritual bodies. They have bodies which are full of eternal, full of bliss and knowledge. But their bodies also have limbs. They have, you know, they have senses, they have forms. They have senses, not material senses, but spiritual senses and spiritual bodies. And the people from Vaikuntha said, we are proof of this. You see, we are associates of the Lord Vishnu, the Lord of Vaikuntha, and we spread devotional service everywhere. But we're not touched by the material nature, although we go everywhere. We're not touched. The material energy does not cover us. So, new devotees, they think devotional service is just something we do with the senses, with the body and the mind. So the beginners, they do devotional service like that. But they do their devotional service very happily, they enjoy it. But actually, the experience is not material. But because we're not very experienced, we don't know very much, we think my tongue is chanting the names of Krishna, my ears hearing the holy name. So they think like that in the beginning because they haven't fully surrendered yet. But those people who are really advanced in devotional service, they do not think that service is are under the, they do not think their activities are material. They don't think that they're just doing these things on their own, but they understand that it's all the mercy of the Lord. They don't act independently. They act under the direction of the Supreme Lord. So the people from Vaikuntha told Gopkumar that you should go and see the Vaikuntha. You said if you want to go to Vaikuntha, then first you go to Vrindavan. And go back to Vrindavan and then you can come to Vaikuntha from Vrindavan. So Gokumar was thinking maybe he should go to Shiva, go to Lord Shiva's place. He was thinking maybe he should go to Shiva Loka and stay there for a while and then go to Vaikuntha. But the people from Vaikuntha said, better you go first to Vrindavan. Yeah, because if he goes back to Vrindavan, it will be easy for him to practice pure devotional service, beginning with hearing and chanting. So they tell the people from Vaikuntha tell Gopkumar, we want you to practice devotional service by doing Nam Sankirtan. The Nam Sankirtan will help you a lot to make progress so that you can get the shelter of the Lord's lotus feet. Nam Sankirtan means loud chanting of the holy name, and it's the best way to go to Vaikuntha.
Nam Sankirtan 意思就是大声地唱诵圣名, 这是去Vaikuntha的最好方式。
But you have to do the chanting in pure devotion without any desire for karma or jnana, no material desire.
Sankirtan. Sankirtan， 没有任何 karma 果报或是 gyana 思辨的欲望，没有任何物质的动机。
And if you do that kind of devotion, then very quickly you will awaken Krishna Prem, love of God, and then you will easily see Krishna in Vaikuntha.
如果从事这一类的奉爱服务，就能够发展起 Krishna Prem， 这样就能很容易的去 Vaikuntha 见到 Krishna.
Now some people may think that remembering is better than chanting.
有些人可能会认为意念要抵制念诵更好。
Because some people think that, well, it's chanting is easy. We just use the speech, but it's not necessarily that.We're very conscious of the Lord when we do the chanting.
有些人呢，他们可能有这种想法，念诵、唱诵只是使用了言语的功能，那不一定呢。在行使这个功能的时候呢，就觉知着主。
Just like when Gop Kumar went to Tapaloka.There, the four Kumaras were saying that remembering is the best process of yoga, not chanting.
Gopa Kumar 先前去了 Tapaloka， 在那里见到 Kumar 四兄弟，而四位 Kumar 就说，意念是更好的，而并非念诵、聆听。
They were saying that kirtan, if you just do the chanting, that's only one sense. You only use the sense of speech. It's one of the working senses. It's not conscious. But if you do the memory, it's more powerful. But if you, the better bhakti is remembering, because then the form will appear within the mind.Then this, if we fix the mind on the Lord, then the mind is brought under control and becomes purified. So the mind is the head of the senses, it controls, gives the direction to the senses.So if the mind is controlled, then the senses are also controlled.
心意是感官之主，心意指导着所有感官，心意得到控制，感官便得到控制。
So the people from the Tapaloka, headed by the four Kumaras, they have the opinion that.The process of remembering is the best way, the best way controlling one's mind. If you want to control the mind, engage it in remembering the Lord.
Tapaloka 的居民们，就是以斯库马尔兄弟为首的居民们的意见是，意念是最好的方法，因为意念控制了心意，当心意得到控制，就很容易能够控制的感官。
But the people from Vaikuntha say no. We consider chanting to be the best form of devotion, better than remembering.
Vaikuntha 的人士们，他们持不同意见。他们说，并非如此。我们认为唱 送是最好的方法，它比意念要好。
And if we do the chanting properly, then of course it will control our speech, but it will also control the mind and the sense of hearing. So when you do proper kirtan, then there's also hearing and remembering. And chanting also helps other people who are not practicing. That the other people, they will hear the chanting, it benefits them. But remembering, that's just something we do inside, doesn't benefit others. Kirtan also will help us to bring our mind under control. So, we recommend this kirtan for you. When we chant, then all the external and internal senses begin to also act, and they're brought under control. Then the mind will become peaceful, and then we can remember Krishna. So remembrance is the fruit of the chanting. Yeah, when we do the chanting properly, then naturally there will come about remembrance of Krishna. Okay, so we will stop here today. Any questions?
好，接下来我们来看问题。第一个是 Chandra Elasani Devadasi， 顶拜 Guru 甜美的莲花族，顶拜奉献者们，请教 Guru， 我昨天看把盘4.22.46。要指说，世上一切属于 Brahmana 和 Vaishnava， 沙弥和商人监管一切。何时 Brahmana 需要钱？他们请教 Guru， 我平常听到一些奉献者说，想给 Krishna 干一些大事，那因为他们缺钱，这种情况是不是说明还不是真正的？But yesterday, read Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 4, Chapter 22, Verse 46, in the purport. Srila Prabhupada said that everything in the world belongs to Brahman and Vaishnava. Kshatriya and merchant, businessmen, they monitor everything. Whenever Brahmana needs money, they will provide them. My question is that in the ordinary time, I said that they will do a big service for Krishna. That means they are in need of money.
The brahmanas are in need of money.
The devotee around her, they said they want to do some big service for Krishna. That means that they need money. So, in that case, so that's not a real Vaishnava or devotional servants, because they haven't pleased the Guru and Krishna, and not they like this. The purport here, it says that Brahmana and Vaishnava can get money whenever they want to do service for Krishna.
Yeah. Well, yes, it's correct. Actually, Krishna provides. If we have a genuine need, Krishna will provide. Prabhupada did not worry about money. He only preached Krishna consciousness. And people would come forward and they would want to give money. So, there is certainly some truth there that, you know, we're suspicious of people who come to us asking for money, because we want to make sure that they're actually genuine before we would give anything. We want to make sure that they have a genuine purpose in mind.
所以您说的话确实是里面也有一些真理的当有人呢就过来想要钱的时候我们自然而然的就会有起一些疑心我们要确保他们是真心真意的从事服务并且他们的目标真正的是服务
Some people talk about doing big service, but are they actually qualified to do some big service?
有些人呢，他们就是高谈阔论，要做服务什么的，但是他们是不是有真正的这样做服务的资格呢？
Sometimes it happens that somebody may give money to unqualified people, and the money is wasted.
有时候情况是这样的。 人们有的奉献成了，他们去管别人要钱，但是呢，人们就会掏钱，结果呢，因为他们缺乏资格，所以这些钱财浪费了。
And sometimes devotees are over ambitious. They do not know their actual qualification, and they try to do more than they're actually able to do.
有的奉献者呢，他们过于野心勃勃，但是却对自己的资格没有一个真正的了解评价，他们所做的服务超越了他们的能力范畴。
So, somebody wants to do some big preaching, it has to be done under with the approval of the senior body of Vaishnavas.
有奉献者想从事很大的传播活动，这一切应该是在资深的 Vaishnava 的委员会的指导。
So the local leaders should be approached, and the local leaders, they should take instruction from the national leaders.
全国性的领导,
and the national leaders may have to take direction from the international leaders.
而这个国家就是全国性的领导呢，又应该去找国际的领导。
So nothing should be done independently. That's the point. You want to do some big preaching, it has to be with approval.
应当得到批准。
So we tell devotees that don't give any money away to people without proper approval for what they're going to do.
就拿就把钱就给了别人，除非他们所做的活动，他们即将从事的活动是得到了批准，这时候再拿钱。Okay,
next question.
那下一个问题是，十二组李碧平，感谢Guru翻译主持。 如何把 Krishna 放在心意中？具体方法。 Thank you, Guru, translator and host. My question is that, how can I put Krishna in my mind? Can you give any specific method?
Chanting Hare Krishna is the method by which you can put Krishna in your heart, in your mind.
唱诵Hare Krishna是你把Krishna放在你的心意当中的方法。Try
to join in the Sankirtan, where there's nice congregational chanting. Try to join in the chanting party.
加入Sankirtan, 集体的吟诵吟唱圣名。
Now there are many recordings of kirtan, so you can play some recordings of devotees chanting, and you can chant along with them. This way, keep Krishna in your mind.
以这种方式把Krishna放在心里当中。下一个问题。下一个，还是Chandra Vilasini的答谢而请教。嗯。啊，马德吉，上面还有两个问题。哦，sorry，对不起。嗯。嗯，马山呢？下，宝山呢？Sunari。 顶拜Guru Maharaj的莲花组，感恩翻译，感恩主持，顶拜所有奉献者的莲花组，帮朋友问个问题：如果从小培养一个充满 Krishna 知觉的孩子，而这孩子终究要在物质世界生存，从幼儿园到大学，他不会失去动力去学习，会不会不去争取在物质世界让自己？ 能生存的物质基础，就像是赖姐群中那封建者，有了病自己无法靠自己的能力去医治。学习，因为学习首要目的是为了自己先能养活自己，不给别人添麻烦。那如果这样的孩子，他就是失去了在物质世界生存的物质基础，比如说物质上特别贫穷。
So this
analogy, ask a question on behalf of a friend. If we have cultivated a Krishna conscious child, but the child has ultimately have to exist in the material world from the kindergarten to the university, won't this child lose the desire to momentum to live in the material world? Because first of all, the child has to have to maintain themselves and don't give burden to other people and be very poor in the material world. Like there's a devotee in a group, this devotee has got some illness and have no ability to cure himself or herself and have to depend on others.
Yes, well, certainly if somebody has a health problem, then then they have to make arrangements to take care of that. We have seen in the past, some devotee had a health problem, and devotees helped him, and helped him to recover, and he recovered his health and became a very good devotee. So, we have to consider the ability of the devotees. Are the devotee? Is there a great burden for them to help a devotee who's sick? If he's a devotee but he's sick, if you can help him, then it's very nice. You're doing nice service for Krishna. Krishna's devotee, serve Krishna's devotee is pleasing to Krishna. So you have to consider the circumstances. I don't know enough about the situation. If somebody is not a devotee, if they haven't been a devotee, then it's not really possible that we can get involved to help them. They should have been devotees. Okay, 下一个问题.
Hare Krishna.
我把那个问题呢，我想重新再重复一下。我想这个奉献者他是想问，就是我们在培养Krishna知觉的孩子的时候，他担心就是从小培养了孩子的灵性知识，但是他在 物质生活当中的生存能力会有问题，会担心是不是孩子长大了以后，在这个物质生活不能有自己的这个生活能力，就是像赚钱啊、工作呀这样的问题。
Well, everything depends on the karma. even though a child may go to school and get material education, doesn't mean he's going to get a job and be able to make a lot of money. There are so many people who went to school and who went to university, they can't find job. They're out of work. They're not able to make any money. They can't find any job. So it's not just only good. Don't think just because you get some material education, your life is going to be so good. But if one is a devotee, if he's trained as a devotee, then he develops good qualities, he has good character, and he may have to work, he may have to find a job, you have to do whatever's necessary. Certainly his karma will be much better. He will have a much better hope because he's taken shelter of the spiritual energy. He said if he's dedicated his life to Krishna consciousness. We see devotees do jobs like cooking. That's a brahminical job. They cook to cook nice prasadam for people. People often need cooks. And another job which people often do is the puja, to worship the deities. Of course, you have to examine the nature of the child. Is the child actually serious to be a devotee? Does he practice properly? Does he behave well? Does he have good qualities? We cannot force people to become devotees. They have to want to be devotees. And they should have the proper qualification. They should behave properly. They should be obedient. They should not be lazy. They should respond to good training.
他们有没有恰当的资质，他们的行为举止如何，他们是不是顺从，他们是不是勤勉不懒惰，他们是不是能够接受正确的很好的培训？
Yeah, can we train them to be clean, to keep everything clean, and to be honest? These kind of qualities are important to make someone a devotee.
这些呢是使一个人变成奉献者的也需要的条件。
Of course, one also has to have faith in Krishna. If you don't have faith in Krishna, then okay, let the child go to the ordinary school. You have faith in that. You have faith in the material education. Then let the child go there and have material education. But if you have faith in Krishna, then you'll want the child to actually become a devotee.
他是不是对信息的这样的人，他是不是真的相信 Krishna 这个孩子？如果他并不相信 Krishna， 那就让他去物质世界接受物质的教育。但如果这样的孩子呢，他对 Krishna 有信心，那就应该让他从事接受灵性的教育。
怎么样 ，Sati Mataji， 可以吗？
好的，谢谢
Gurudev。下一个问题是 Janaka Das 的问题。顶拜 Guru 林阿祖，顶拜翻译各位奉献者，请问 Guru， 一 Gopa Kumar 念诵的 Vishnu Mantra 是这个 Hare Krishna Mantra 还是别的？
It's not the Hare Krishna mantra. It's a special mantra he was given by his guru.
It's not the Hare Krishna mantra. It's his guru gave him a special mantra. 二，以前经常听到 Shiva 很容易被取悦，一般取悦别人都说好听的话等方法。今天听到 guru 说 Shiva 另一个品质。他听到赞美之词不高兴，我们该怎样训练自己的心意？该怎样对待别人的赞美呢？ Usually we heard that Shiva is very easy to be pleased. Usually we please a person by praising them. But today you mentioned in your class the other quality of Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva is not pleased to hearhimself being praised. So how can we train our mind? How can we treat the how can we so in front of the praising of other people, so what should we do?
Well,you don't have to praise anyone, and you don't have to criticize anyone. We can just simply glorify Krishna. We don't like to hear people, it's not good for us to be praised, and it's not good also for us to be criticized. So just try to talk things about Krishna, glorify Krishna.
我们不会就是赞美一个人，也不批评一个人。我们荣耀 Krishna， 我们只是荣耀 Krishna。当然我们也不会就是听别人来赞扬我们或者是批评我们，我们只是荣耀就是 Krishna， 谈论有关于 Krishna 的事情。
If someone praises usthen we should not take pleasure in it. We should feel uncomfortable.
如果有人赞扬了我们，我们不会沾沾自喜，我们会觉得不舒服。
Because we become proud. We think, yeah, I'm really a good devotee.
我们就会引以为豪，觉得很骄傲，是的。
And if somebody finds fault with us, that's actually good for us, make us more humble.
倘若有人挑刺儿找我们的毛病，实际上对我是有好处的，会让我们变得谦卑。
But it's not everyone's duty to find fault with another person. That is the job of the spiritual teacher. Spiritual teacher can see the faults, he can tell. But another person has no position, he's not the authority. And if you try to tell someone they're wrong, then they would simply become angry. They think, who are you to tell me? You're not my authority. Okay.
下一个, Chandravilasini, 请教Dardasi, 请教Guru, 你刚才讲到, 意念是唱诵的果实，但我现在唱诵念诵不好。在这种情况下，如果要做好意念Krishna，是不是随时要有意识的，随时想到Krishna形象，想念Krishna呢？感谢Guru的仁慈。You mentioned just now that remembrance is the result, fruit of chanting. But now my chanting is not very good. Under the circumstances, if I need to remember Krishna well, is that at any time I should consciously remind myself of Krishna's form and remember Krishna? Thank you for Guru's mercy.
Yes, you should remember Krishna by chanting his holy name. By chanting the holy name of Krishna, if you chant loudly with powerful desire, then the remembrance of Krishna will come in your mind. How will he come in the mind? Well, he will come in the awareness of the presence of Krishna. Just the feeling that Krishna's there, that Krishna's with you, that he's everywhere.
Krishna如何才能进入到您的心意呢？您要意识到Krishna的临在，感受到Krishna就在那儿，Krishna无处不在。
Just like Prabhupada would say, he's always in Vrindavan. Even though he is in some other country, but he would say, I'm always in Vrindavan because I'm always thinking of Krishna.
Prabhupada总是说，他一直就在Vrindavan，他并不在别的国家，因为Prabhupada他总是想着Krishna.
So you should chant loudly and remember Krishna, and then you can think that you're also in Vrindavan.
Okay.
下一个问题，陈冠江 Chaitanya Charandas 顶拜 Gurudev 和奉献者们，在中国很多人都说要管理奉献者，强调管理，有时候看看好像也没多少奉献者，一个地方就那么几个奉献者，没啥好管理的，个个都专注管理，谁来传播 Krishna 之觉？没有足够的 Krishna 之觉能管理好，没有足够 Krishna 之觉能管理好奉献者吗？能传播好 Krishna 之觉吗？怎样理解管理和传教的关系呢？
Okay, and what is the relationship between managing and preaching? Because there's people all want to do managing and nobody wants to go preaching. If everybody's a manager, there'll be no preaching. So what is the relationship? So the relationship is that managing means preaching. You want to manage, there must be preaching. You have to preach. And the preaching begins with the devotees. Yeah, of course, the two are related. You want people to preach. There has to be nice management. If the management is not good, then people won't want to go preaching.
这两者是有联系的。如果没有好的管理的话，人们就没有去传播的动力了。
If you don't have a nice mood with the devotees, if you're always arguing with each other, then people won't want to preach.
如果跟奉献者之间没有很好的这种氛围的话，如何总是奉献之间在那里争执的话，就没有什么，就不会有什么传播。
And if they don't have nice prasada, then people will not be happy, and people will not be eager to preach. So managing is dealing with these things, making nice arrangements for prasadam, making nice programs. This attracts people. So it's also preaching.
如果没有好吃的 prasadam, 奉献者就不会很高兴，就不会去渴望去传播了。所以管理呢，涉及到的就是所有上述的这些问题 ，prasadam 啊，节日啊，让非常去吸引人，这个就是传教。
Well, we have to manage. We have to There has to be people who manage, and there has to be preachers, and both are very important. They're very much related to each other.
需要有很好的管理者，也需要有优秀的传教者，这个两者都很重要，他们是密不可分的。
Managing is a very difficult job because it's very hard to please people.
管理是很难的工作，因为要讨好别人，取悦别人可不那么容易。
You get people who come, all they do is criticize, they always complain. They never see anything good. They never do any service, all they do is complain.
有的人他来了，他只是一味的那里批评，一味的在抱怨。这种人呢，他从来不看好的地方，他从来不做服务。只是在那里一味抱怨。
So we should be respectful to the manager. Someone's willing to take up that responsibility to be manager. They should be given respect because it's not an easy job. We should respect every devotee. Lord Chaitanya is teaching Amanena Mana Dena, that we have to offer all respects to others and not to be eager to be respected ourselves. So the managers also have to be respectful. They have to be respectful to the devotees. They should be the servant manager.
管理者们应当受到尊重。 这管理者他应该是 the manager should be servant the devotee, right?
Yes.
管理者们应该是做仆人奉献者。
That's the service. Managing means to be the servant of the devotees.
这是他们的服务，管理者们应该是成为奉献者们的仆人。
Okay. How you went, Ma?
下一个，还有最后一个问题。
请丁拜咕噜，天门莲花组请教咕噜。我们在与奉献者相处的时候，有时候跟奉献者在一起说好听的赞美话，感觉一下关系就拉近了。对方愿意说更多，那么说的赞美的话，增强了自己的幻觉能量。那这种情况下，还要不要说赞美的话？感恩咕噜的仁慈。
Funny.
When we are together with the other devotees, sometimes the nice words will bring our relationship more close. The others will like to reveal themselves more easily. But on the other hand, those praising words will enhance our illusionary energy. So under the circumstances, should we speak nice words, praising words?
Generally, we want to praise Krishna and the spiritual master, like Prabhupada. We want to praise Prabhupada and Krishna. Praise these people. These are pleasing words.
通常我们要赞美的是 Krishna, 赞美灵性导师，赞美 Prabhupada.
And you can
对这些人说赞美之词。
You can also praise the good fortune of all the devotees.
也可以赞美所有奉献者他们的好运气。
So this is, these words are pleasing to everyone.
这样的赞美之词呢，是人人都会感到心满意足的。 The next one.
Yeah.
唐东，唐吉东啊，大姐。顶拜咕噜翻译你好，有些修行人总说一切随缘，都是命中安排。如果都这样想。 是不是就什么都不去做了？反正都已经命中注定了，争取徒劳，修行是不是也没用啊？ Some people, when they are practicing, they always say that everything is destined, everything is already arranged. So in that case, so. We shouldn't endeavor, that would be useless. So in that case,
Is it also use this to practice? Is this saying is cheating to ourselves?
Yes, right. That's the proper understanding. This is one way of cheating ourselves.
是的，这种理解是正确的。就这种说法是骗自己。
We may say, well, everything is arranged by Krishna, so I'll just sit back and do nothing. But we cannot sit back and do nothing.
我们会说啊，一切都是 Krishna 的安排，然后我们就坐在那里无所事事了。但是我们不应该就坐在那里什么也不做。
The material nature, the modes of nature forces us to act.
物质自然是强迫每个人在那里活动着。
We cannot just simply sit and say, well, let Krishna do everything. Okay, so sit, let Krishna feed you. You don't need to eat, you just sit there, Krishna will come and feed you himself.
你会说，让 Krishna 安排吧。那好吧，那你就坐在那里，等着 Krishna 过来给你喂饭好了。Krishna 会亲自过来给你喂饭的。
So people often speak philosophy, but they cannot apply it.
有人常常呢，他们是对哲学说很多，但是却无法把这些哲学加以实际的运用实践。
So you want to practice, yeah, more questions?
Yes, there's another question.
Okay.
顶拜 Guru, 感恩翻译。我从小被收养，现在已经有结婚，有了自己的家庭。生父母期待我们能相认，养父母不乐意。我也渐渐被生父母更加纯粹的爱吸引。生父身体不好，我先请求养母的同意，再去看他好吗？感恩。So, this devotee has been adopted by the other parents, and he or she has already got married and has own family. But the original parents want to meet with this devotee.But adopted, the later parents are not very happy. But he or she was attracted by the pure love of the original parents and the father. The real father is not very healthy. Can I first of all beg forgiveness, beg the approval from my adopted mother, and then to go to see my real father. Is that okay?
Well, if you, I don't know who you're staying with. If she's staying with her adopted mother and father, then she will have to get permission from them. Yeah.
我不知道您现在是不是就跟您的养父母生活在一起。如果您现在目前是跟养父母一起生活在一起的话，是应该征求这个养母的同意。
You know, they adopted you, they brought you up. Did they arrange all your marriage also?
他们收养了你，然后他们又为你安排了婚姻。
You know, you have a lot to be grateful to them. They've done a lot for you.They've helped you, they've raised you, they've got you married, and then so you're indebted to the new parents. I don't know why your original mother and father had you adopted, why they gave you away, I don't know. It's unusual.I don't know all the circumstances.
我不了解您的具体情况，不知道 为什么你的生身父母要把你给予别人来抚养？
So I don't want to give you advice about this situation. You have to. Somebody has to. I'd have to know much more about the whole situation before I tell you one way or the other.
嗯，所以我不想给你提任何建议，我必须要了解更多的情况才可以去提建议。
But certainly you want to be careful and respect the adopted parents.
但是无疑您是希望小心的对待这件事情，而且尊重。
Okay, Hare Krishna.
Now there's another question being raised up by Sati Mataji.
Okay.
金丽荣，顶拜 Guru Maharaj 莲花族，请问如何理解取悦奉献者和取悦 Krishna， 以及当取悦一位奉献者？就会伤害另一位奉献者时应该怎么做？
Please, one devotee, and you may give unhappiness or discomfort or suffering to another devotee.
Yes, I want to understand how to understand between pleasing devotee and pleasing Krishna. And the other part of the question is that.If I please one devotee and then we hurt another devotee, so what should I do?
Well, we should try to please Krishna. That's the important point. Please Krishna, Guru and Krishna.
应该取悦 Krishna, 这是重要的事情。要取悦 Guru, 取悦 Krishna.
If you just please one devotee and give pain to suffering to another devotee, that's not very good. We want to be cautious about that. We will have to be careful about how we deal with devotees.
如果取悦了一位奉献者就伤害另外一位奉献者，这不好。你应该小心，要对这样的事情呢要谨慎，和奉献者打交道要。
And devotee relationships can be very sensitive, and so you have to deal very cautiously. If you know something is not going to please another devotee, then why you would do it?
If you know
another devotee is not going to like what you're doing, if they're going to get upset, then better not to do.
Okay, 奉献者的关系呢，这个是一个敏感的话题。奉献者的关系是非常敏感的，所以要谨慎。如果你知道，做一件事儿是另外一个奉献者不喜欢的话，最好就不去做。
Yeah. You want to please Krishna means pleasing all the devotees.
取悦 Krishna 就意味着已经取悦了所有奉献者了。
Okay. 现在呢？
Okay.
结束了吗？
是的，
对，
我没有更多的问题了。
Hare Krishna. Okay, 谢谢大家 ，Hare Krishna， 谢谢 Guru Mani， 谢谢 Sati， 所有的奉献者 ，Hare Bol。